that we breathe, that we move, that we have our being, you know, we can go our way, or we can take the time to make it a day that we could rejoice in, and to seek God, to find if He's involved in our personal life, or if He's just distant, you know, like manipulating the circumstances, kind of like a puppet master, you know, and you're on strings, and that, you know, you're kind of letting circumstances dictate, you know, what you're doing, and sometimes you're up, and sometimes you're down, and sometimes you're like this, you know. But God doesn't want to be a puppet master, you know, controlling your circumstances. He wants to be your master, sharing with you love in a way that you get to look and see who it is that isn't pulling your strings, but you are attached to by way of love. Because, see, love binds you to the person that you love. It isn't controlled by puppet masters, but rather causes your emotions to develop a connection with God that, in a very powerful way, you just want to do those things that are pleasing to Him, and that gives Him pleasure, and that makes you feel good, that's true, but also in some way connects you with the Father in a deep, more intimate way. Devotions are like that. He likes to share with us what He has for us today, tomorrow, and the next day. But He only does it one day at a time. In daily life, Thou art a gracious God and merciful, slow to anger and of great kindness, and repentest Thee of the evil. I beseech Thee that the power of my Lord be great according as Thou hast spoken, saying, The Lord is long-suffering and of great mercy, forgiving iniquity and transgression, and by no means clearing the guilty, visiting the iniquity of the fathers upon the children unto the third and the fourth generations. For remember not against us former iniquities, that Thy tender mercies speedily prevent us. Help us, O God of our salvation, for the glory of Thy name, and deliver us, and purge away our sins for Thy name's sake. O Lord, though our iniquities testify against us, do Thou it for Thy name's sake. For our backslidings are many. We have sinned against Thee. We acknowledge, O Lord, our wickedness and the iniquity of our fathers, for we have sinned against Thee. If Thou, Lord, should mark iniquity, O Lord, who shall stand? But there is forgiveness with Thee, that Thou mayest be feared. You know, people tell me all the time about their circumstances, how they cause them to become anxious or become worried or to take a step, you know, where they think that they got to do something. But in reality, God says, look, turn to Me and I will do something. But when you turn to your own devices, then you're going to manipulate or be manipulated. And when you're manipulating, you're putting yourself in the place of God. When you're being manipulated, you're being a servant of someone who doesn't want you to accomplish your purposes, Satan. So if Satan is the god of the prince of the power of the air, and he's the god of this world, and then he's behind princes, principalities, powers, and spiritual wickedness in high places, do you think we ought to be like seeking God for His answers to political situations and personal relativity and the idea that, guess what, God might want to take care of you more than you can take care of it yourself? Sometimes I think that social events and patriotic ideas get lost in the reality of being in a king with a kingdom. Sanctification of the Spirit. Awake, O north wind, and come, thou south. Blow upon my garden, and the spices may flow out. Behold, this selfsame thing, that you sorrowed after a godly sort, what carefulness it wrought in you, yea, what clearing of yourself, what indignation, what fear, what vehement desire, what zeal, what revenge. Fruit of the Spirit is in all godliness, goodness, and righteousness and truth, proving what is acceptable unto the Lord. The Comforter is the Holy Ghost. The love of God is shed abroad in our hearts by the Holy Ghost which is given unto us. The fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace. In a great trial of affliction, the abundance of their joy and their deep poverty abounded unto the riches of their liberality. All of these worketh that one and selfsame Spirit, dividing to every man severally as He will. Often when I see people get carried away about the Spirit. They focus in on the Spirit of God rather than Jesus, which the Spirit of God, we are told, points us to. Sometimes people get carried away with this idea of being a prophet or a teacher or pastor or leader or whatever they may be, and they put these titles on themselves. And the Spirit of God really wants to develop in us the graces of God, which is the mercy, the tenderness, the kindness, the trust, the faith, the joy, the passion, the excitement that there is in knowing God, not in showing God. You see, when you feel excited, you want to show off a little bit, whether you know it or not. A lot of people in religious circles show off, because Jesus said most of what we do, we should do behind the scenes and kind of out of the limelight. But most of what you see in a religious circle is in the spotlight. So don't take too seriously what you see in the spotlight, but rather when it's in God's light, recognize that He's developing in you His Spirit, that you might be full of mercy and love and kindness towards other people, as opposed to in the spotlight, which we can always pick out, you know, what we see wrong and not cling to what is right. So don't get caught up in the world and its ways, or even in the religious world, because it's too easy to take a light and shine it on somebody and see all their faults, when the light of God's word is one of love, because God is love, of mercy, of extending mercy to someone, of forgiveness because they need it. Obviously you do. You're not perfect. That's what God wants for us, by His Spirit.